Indian News 24 Hour.
Chidambaram said that Congress will be a formidable challenge in 2019 polls. Former finance minister partly credited NOTA votes for Congress loss. Betting for Rahul Gandhi, Chidambaram said he will grow to be assertive party president. 2 days after the winner limped across the finish line in the crucial assembly election in Gujarat with a young sprinter close on his heels, Congress stalwart and former Union Finance Minister P. Chidambaram staunchly defended the party's performance, saying the Bharatiya Janata Party's BJP dream of a India without the grand old party has been dashed. In an exclusive interview with India Today, Chidambaram said that the Congress will be a formidable challenge to the BJP in the 2019 general election. The Gujarat performance clearly showed that the BJP's dream of a Congress-free India has vanished, he added. On D-Day, Chidambaram had tweeted, "There is an electoral victory and there is a political victory. Need I say who is the political victor in Gujarat?" When asked that despite the Congress political victory in Gujarat, it was the BJP, which was Jojita Wohi Sikander, he shot back, "Why didn't you say Jojita Wohi Sikander in Goa and Manipur, where the BJP stole the elections," referring to the BJP's claim to form governments despite the Congress emerging as the largest party. Lauding the Congress performance in Gujarat, Chidambaram said, "We were the underdog. No opinion poll gave us more than 665 seats. The BJP could not reach the 150 mark despite having several advantages like being the incumbent party, Prime Minister Narendra Modi and BJP President Amit Shah belonging to the state, and unlimited resources. The BJP crossed the line, but we were close on its heels with 80 seats. On the BJP's vote share rising to 49.1% from 47.85% in the last polls and the party crossing the magical number of 92 despite being in power for the last 22 years, the Congress leader said, "Being the incumbent for 22 years was balanced by the fact that Gujarat is the home state of the PM and Amit Shah. I am not denying the BJP's win, but it could not reach the 150 mark." When asked whether the Congress could have won Gujarat, the former FM said that a little more luck, better organization and pulling all party heavyweights together would have done the job. "We may have not crossed the magical number of 92, but winning 80 is an achievement with all odds stacked against us." Chidambaram agreed that the BJP, under Modi, connected to Gujarat's urban areas in a better way than the Congress. Out of 55 urban seats, the BJP bagged 43 and the Congress only 12. "I agree, but in the 2009 general elections, we won all major cities despite being the incumbent, with the BJP winning only Bengaluru. But there was no Modi in 2009. Don't attribute the Gujarat win to one person. The BJP did connect in a better way to urban voters, but that can't be the scenario in every election." Chidambaram blames NOTA for Congress loss. Chidambaram countered the defeat of Congress stalwarts like Shakta Singhgohil, Arjun Madhvadia, Tushar Chaudhary and Siddharth Patel by saying, "Hal Fatos and BJP ministers and the speaker lost their seats." The Gujarat polls saw the rise of outsiders in the Congress like Thacker community leader Alpesh Thacker and Dalit chief Jignesh Mavani, who mobilized the masses and dented the BJP's prospects. Chidambaram agreed that these leaders had mobilized supporters, but said, "Ultimately, the Congress did the main organizational work, carried the burden. Social mobilization helped, but only to a point. A BJP overcoming the GST and demonetization double whammy in the state, farmers and traders' anger and the Patidar agitation to win the polls." Chidambaram quipped, "Why are you counting the GST and demonetization as a negative for the BJP? It had boasted of winning the UP elections by molding the demonetization narrative. Why has it become a burden in Gujarat?" The Congress veteran blamed the NOTA votes for the Congress loss in cities like Surat, where the business class was initially angry with the BJP over the GST, but finally voted for it. "I am not denying the BJP's win in such cities. If NOTA votes came to us, we would have won." Chidambaram batted for Rahul when asked whether the Gandhi sign will be able to sustain his energized and transformed avatar. "Of course, he has matured as vice president. He is matured and more confident, and understands responsibilities of the high office. He will grow and be more assertive as president." Rahul had received much flack for his 15-day New Year break after the Congress was routed in the 2014 general elections. Will he again jet to a foreign nation after the Gujarat loss? "Don't repeat irrelevant arguments given by antediluvian people. All political leaders take breaks. All I know is Rahul Gandhi will put his shoulder to the wheel and work as president. There is nothing wrong in going on holidays. Don't South Asian leaders take breaks. Chidambaram shot back. Chidambaram also refuted reports that the Congress was trying to move towards soft Hindutva when asked why Congress President Rahul Gandhi's visited 28 temples during the hustings. "You don't understand the nature of campaigning in rural areas. I come from a rural constituency. Every village in Tamil Nadu has a temple or a mosque or church. Usually, when leaders campaign in villages, the voters request them to visit temples and mosques. But when Rahul Gandhi goes to temple, it makes news. On pictures of Rahul brandishing his Janu, or the sacred thread," Chidambaram said, "he was just participating in rituals regarding his deceased father." He also denied reports on the AK Antony committee findings, which had claimed that the Congress was pro-minority. "I have not read it, I don't know. Watch Chidambaram on Gujarat verdict Jojita Wohi Sikandar cliche."